Hi, I'm Alicia, and today we're going over WordPress Redirect best practices to maximize SEO and page speed. When you're redesigning a website or updating old content, changes to your URL structures are likely. And if you don't follow WordPress Redirect best practices, you risk negatively impacting the user experience and your search engine optimization. In this video, we'll explain the importance of WordPress redirects and how they influence page speed and, of course, SEO. Before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember to subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Redirects exist for a reason. They allow you to send visitors from outdated content and non-existent URLs to updated content. There are several scenarios where redirects are appropriate, including you've posted updated content and want to steer visitors away from the older version. You've overhauled a website's permalink structure and need to redirect old URLs to their new structure. Or you're updating a published page or post and want to temporarily redirect traffic to a different post or page while you work on the update. When is it not appropriate to use a WordPress redirect? If you've built a custom menu using URLs that don't include www, but your site URL does resolve with the www subdomain at the front of the URL, you're making a mistake. Using redirects in that scenario is not appropriate and hurts the speed and SEO of your site. If you're sold on the idea of minimizing redirects in WordPress, there are two important things you need to do. The first thing to remember is to never intentionally create unnecessary redirects. For example, you shouldn't create redirects when building internal links and menus. If you've gotten into the habit of typing URLs lazily, it's best to rethink the way you're working. Instead, when you create a URL, make sure that you use the proper protocol prefix, HTTP or HTTPS. Include or exclude the www subdomain as appropriate. Don't use post and page IDs in links. Include the entire path to the page or post. The redirection power built into WordPress is supposed to be a fallback in case you accidentally create a bad URL. It's not a very reliable fix for lazy URL writing in general. The second thing you can do to minimize the occurrence of WordPress redirects is to make sure your top-level domain, or TLD, resolves with no more than one redirection. Your goal is to make sure that the correct URL is reached through one redirection or less, no matter what combination of protocol prefix and subdomain a visitor throws in front of the TLD. Let's look at an example. All of the following URLs should resolve the TLD with no more than one redirection, and one of these should resolve with no redirects. We do find that some of those combinations either fail to resolve, returning a 404 server status code, or require more than one redirection to resolve. It's time to get to work. One method you can take for setting up a WordPress redirect is to add one or more redirection rules to your server. This will ensure that visitors land at the proper formulation of your site's URL as quickly as possible. The basic goal you're trying to accomplish is to create redirect rules that target any URL formulations requiring more than one redirection. You want to force those URLs to resolve directly to the properly formulated URL. For example, if the URL http://// requires two redirects to get to https://, you can create a manual redirection that makes that happen in one step rather than two. If your site is hosted on a standard LAMP stack, you'll need to add URL rewriting rules to your site's .htaccess file. Setting up a WordPress redirect through a web server configuration file is a technical process and can be complicated. Therefore, only use this method if you're comfortable with editing your .htaccess file. Even if you are, it's still a good idea to create a backup of the file first. Then the first step is to connect your WordPress installation using an FTP client or through your hosting cPanel's file manager. You can locate the .htaccess file in the root directory of your WordPress site. Then the first step is to connect to your WordPress installation using an FTP client or through your hosting cPanel's file manager. You can locate the .htaccess file in the root directory of your WordPress site. To set up a 301 redirect, you'll need to specify the old and new URL locations with a syntax structure that looks like this. If you want to redirect all of your site's traffic from HTTP to HTTPS, you can use the following code. Keep in mind that before doing this, it's important to make sure you have your SSL certificate properly configured on the new WordPress site. If you feel confident in your abilities, you can create a redirect in Nginx by creating a server block for the content you want to redirect using the following code. In this directive, return is used for a URL substitution. It returns the status code specified in the redirection URL. The scheme variable uses the scheme from the original HTTP or HTTPS request and returns the 301 redirect code with the new URL. Another option is to use this code. This can be used to create a permanent redirect. If your site is hosted by Kinsta, setting up redirects is easy. You can use your redirect rules tool in MyKinsta to create 301 and 302 redirects. After you log into your MyKinsta, click on your site and go to redirects, followed by Add Redirect Rule. Next, on the Add Redirect Rule screen, you can choose which domain prefix to add the redirect for. Typically, you'll want to redirect both www and non-www traffic, in which case you'll choose all domains. Once that's clear, you'll need to fill out the redirect from and redirect to fields. Under HTTP status code, you can easily choose which type of redirect rule you want to use, 301 or 302. When happy with your choice, click on Add Redirect Rule. Keep in mind that because our redirect tool uses regex automatically, you should add a caret before every from path. This will keep it from creating a redirect loop with other URLs. While this tool is pretty straightforward, you can always get in touch with support if you have any questions or need help. Adding redirects in MyKinsta means the rules are implemented at the server level, which is the optimal way. However, there are also WordPress plugins through which you can implement redirects for WordPress sites. Before taking a closer look at redirect plugins, it's important to note that using them can sometimes cause performance issues. Most of them utilize the wp_redirect function, which requires additional code execution and resources. If your host doesn't have a redirect rules feature, you might have to use a WordPress plugin. There are many redirection plugins available, and Redirection is one of the most popular ones you can use. This plugin is very easy to use, plus it's free. Here's how to get started with the Redirection plugin. After you download it from the plugin directory, you can locate it by going to Tools and then Redirection. This will bring you to a welcome page. Click on the Start Setup button, then follow the series of prompts. Once it's done, you can begin using it. You can manually add a new redirection by clicking on the Add New button, then inputting the source and target URLs into the respective form fields and clicking on the Add Redirect button. This approach is only recommended if you have just a few URLs to redirect. If you're dealing with an entire site's worth, you're encouraged to save time by using the plugin's URL import feature. Another helpful way you can use this plugin is to import and export redirects. For example, you can export old URLs from your website, then use the plugin on a new site to import the list. To do this, install and activate the Redirection plugin on your old website. Next, from your WordPress admin dashboard and go to Tools and then Redirection and then Import/Export. At the bottom of the screen, under Export, you can export everything to a CSV, Apache.htaccess, Nginx rewrite rules, or Redirections JSON file. Then, with the plugin installed on your new site, you can go to the same screen to import the file. Click on the Add File button and select the file. Once it's uploaded, you can find the new URLs listed under the Redirects tab. Plain and simple, if implemented poorly, WordPress Redirects can slow down your site. That's why it's worth taking the time to minimize the number of redirects. By limiting the use of redirection to necessary instances and using WordPress Redirect best practices, you help ensure that your visitors have the fastest experience possible and your conversion rates won't decline. Plus, you won't have to worry about hurting your SEO and losing your rankings. What are your thoughts? Have you experienced performance issues due to too many redirects? Let us know in the comments section below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo from our MyKinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.